Welcome back to our channel Class Like Community. So today we will be dealing with the lecture 6 of module 5, that is about the dielectrics. So what we will cover in this lecture are dielectric materials. Second is the expression for static dielectric constant. Third is the types of polarization. So without wasting more time, let's begin. So first of all, we will know what is dielectric material. So a dielectric, or you can say dielectric material, is an electrical insulator. Okay, so it is an electrical insulator. So what is basically an insulator? Can anybody know that? I hope you all know that. But if you don't know, an electrical insulator is a material in which the electron does not flow freely. Or we can say that the atom of the insulator have tightly bound electrons. Or in simple word, electric charges do not flow freely. It doesn't allow the electric charge to flow freely. You can say in that language too. So let's move ahead, and it states that can be polarized by an applied electric field. So what is a dielectric material? So first of all, a dielectric material is an electrical insulator. It can be polarized by an applied electric field. Next, you can state that when a dielectric is placed in the electric field. So you think that type of a electric field is there, a dielectric is there in a electric field. So electric charges do not flow through the material. As insulator opposes the flow of charge, flow of the current, so it will not flow through the material as it does in an electrical conductor. But what happens here, that it will shift slightly from wherever the position is. Think that the position is at A, so it will shift to a position of B. That means it have been shifted from their average equilibrium position, causing dielectric polarization. So now let's move on to the next point, that is, what is dipole? So see, dipole is a two equal and opposite charges. So these are equal, but it's of opposite charges. So if one is plus, another will be minus. And the main point is that it is separated by certain distance. Think of D, which constitutes, or you can say, is called as dipole. So now the next thing is about the polarization. Now what is polarization? Right, the separation of effective center of positive and negative charge in a substances by the application of the electric field. Think like there is a circle. Okay, it is a substances. The circle is the substances. There are many positive charges, there are many negative charges. So when we separate that positive and negative charge effective center by applying some electric field, so it is known as polarization. So now we will see some pictures, and which will state about atoms in a dielectric in the absence of electric field. So you can see that atoms in a dielectric, when there is no electric field, but when there is a presence of electric field, what happens? There is a positive and a negative charges of atom is there, right? Okay, so now we will know about the dipole moment. So see, you need to remember that Q is a charge and L is the separation distance. So dipole moment is mu equal to QL. So in language you can say it is the product of charge and the separation distance. Okay, now atomic polarizability. So atomic polarizability is denoted as small p equal to alpha E, where alpha is the polarization constant. So here this alpha will be the polarization constant. Now we have already know over the polarization, so we should know the polarization formula too. So what happens? Polarization P is equal to dipole moment per unit volume. So it is epsilon r minus I equal to n alpha p of I. Okay, now we will know about polar dielectrics and non-polar dielectrics. So polar dielectrics are those which possess permanent dipole moment. That means there will be permanent dipole moment. They are permanently polarized in nature. Like for example, water, KCl, NH3. But non-polar dielectrics, these are the material which is just the opposite of polar dielectrics. That means it will not possess permanent dipole moment. So they get polarized only in the presence of external electric field. So whenever we will apply electric field, it will start having its polarization. For example, O2, that means oxygen, N2 means nitrogen, H means helium, Ne means neon. So now, without wasting more time, let's move on to our second subtopic, that is the expression for static dielectric constant. So in the absence of dielectric, what happens? Capacitance C. I hope you know what is capacitance, so I'm not repeating. So capacitance C. So here capacitance is represented as C when there is the absence of dielectric. So C without dielectric, it is written. So it is Q by V, we know that. Now it is sigma A, where Q is sigma A and V is sigma D by epsilon naught. So what happens? Sigma get cuts and the epsilon goes up. So what happens? We get the thing as epsilon naught A by D. And just the opposite, there will be a extra, which is epsilon R. That means when in the presence of dielectric, so it will be epsilon R. So static dielectric constant, that is epsilon R, is equal to your C with dielectric, that means the presence of dielectric, by the presence of without dielectric. So you can state that epsilon R is the ratio of capacitance of a capacitor with a dielectric to its capacitance in the absence of dielectric. Okay, now what we will do, we will do the different polarization mechanism, or you can say the types of polarization. There are four possible ways in which polarization can in a dielectric when placed in an electric field. So there are four polarizations. So you can repeat with me. First is a electric polarization. So first is a electric polarization. Second is a ionic polarization. Three is a oriented polarization. Four is a space charge polarization. So for remembrance, what you can do, you can remember as EIOS. EIOS. So EIOS also you can say, EIOS also you can say. So E for electric polarization, I for ionic polarization, O for oriented polarization, S for space charge polarization. So now move ahead and see what is electric polarization. Okay, so electric polarization, these are generally seen in the case of covalent compound. So when we will see our electric polarization, whenever it will be a covalent compound. So now what is a covalent compound, you may be thinking, right? So a covalent compound, when a molecule is formed from the covalent bond, such compounds are called covalent compound. Okay, so these compounds share one or more pair of valence electrons. So if you have forget, so you just remember that whenever a molecule gets formed through a covalent bond, it is a covalent compound. So when this covalent compound is placed in electric field, displacement of electron cloud takes place relative to the nucleus. So there will be a displacement of electric cloud will take place. This displacement creates a dipole, which develops a dipole moment. Okay, now we will move on to our ionic polarization. So as this word says, ionic polarization, so for a pinch of second you will get that this will be exhibited by ionic compound. So when ionic compounds are kept in an electric field, there is a displacement of positive and negative ions occurs, developing a dipole moment. Okay, so now you need to know that ionic polarizability is alpha I because it is ionic, so I equal to epsilon naught bracket epsilon r minus 1 by ni. N is the number of dipoles per unit volume, okay? And in place of the electronic polarizability, what happens? It is alpha e equal to epsilon naught bracket epsilon r minus 1 by n, where n is number of dipoles per unit volume, which is independent of temperature. That means there is no dependency with the temperature. Okay, now we will know about the types of polarization, but now we will know the oriented polarization. So the oriented polarization states that the molecules, that means the polar molecules, exhibit this mechanism. So what happens? Now we will put these polar molecules in electric field. Already existing dipoles tend to align in the direction of applied electric field. So you are seeing, when there is no electric field, they are in different direction. As we are giving it in an electric field, so what happens? As the electric field is this side, so what happens? All the arrows direct on that side only. Okay, now as we have known about the ionic polarization and electronic polarization formula, we need to also know the formula for the orientation polarization, or you can say the oriented polarization. It is alpha O equal to mu square by kT. Okay, mu is the dipole moment. Okay, now we will know about the space charge polarization. This polarization exists in materials possessing different phases due to difference in temperatures. So this polarization exhibits in materials possessing different phases due to difference in temperature. So due to difference in temperature, it will possess in different phases. In such material, charge carriers drift and accommodate in certain regions of higher conductivity, causing dipole moments. It occurs in ferrites and semiconductors. Its magnitude is very small compared to other mechanism. So when there is no field, it was plus minus plus minus plus. When an electric field got applied, what happened? Some charges gets a position to this side, that means in the regions of higher conductivity, causing the dipole. Okay, so these are the basic of types of polarization. That means EOS, right? EIOS, or you can say EOS, that means electronic polarization, ionic polarization, orientation polarization, and space charge polarization. So today's lecture ends here. Till then, be happy and have a great day. And if you have any queries, please comment down below. We will definitely reply to you. And till then, wait for our next lecture. Thank you for watching.
Wow, that's impressive. You have completed a magic today. For more videos, subscribe. Join our Facebook group and Instagram page for group discussion and live magus videos for exam preparation in an hour. We start at Class Like Community for students to learn from a friend in a simple way and support them in their own languages. If you are willing to be that one friend who saves us at the exam night preparation, then please join us by visiting classfly.in.